Last evening at 9 p.m., Ugandans were shocked by news of the sudden passing of prominent businessman Apollo Nyegamahe, commonly known as Aponye. He died in a car crash in Itojo, Ntungamo district, along the Mbarara Kabale road stretch. His car reportedly crashed into a stationary vehicle. His driver and two other people who survived the accident were rushed to hospital. The businessman was reportedly traveling to attend a burial ceremony in his home village in Kigo, Ruchiga district. The deceased owned a string of businesses under his company, Aponye Uganda Limited, including supermarkets, transport and real estate. This morning, mourners gathered at the residence of the late Aponye in Lubowa Machindi Division for the vigil. Among the mourners was the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, former Prime Minister, Dr. Ruhakana Rugunda, and the State Minister for Trade, David Bahati, among others. Tayebwa described the late as one of the largest taxpayers in the country, but also a unique businessman who not only traded in Uganda, but also in countries within East Africa.
It's a very painful moment for the country, not only the country, but the region, especially. Apollo has been feeding the region from South Sudan to DRC, to Rwanda, to Burundi. I know they've all been depending on Apollo. He's been the largest supplier to World Food Program. I remember I met him in 2008, my first time in South Sudan. And all of us were business people, and we were supplying the same item. So we ended up forming a very, very good team until when he gave me his daughter, married in the extended family. Since then, we've been very, 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 very close. I remember at the time when you could find the government of South Sudan, for example, did not have money, but you could extend food and credit for the soldiers in millions of dollars. Very few could have that capacity. One of the largest taxpayers the country had, one of the largest employers the country had.
Members of the business community have agreed to fund all the burial costs of the late Aponye to honor him. Tayebwa said by the time Aponye died, he had introduced many of his children to his businesses, which was a wise decision given the tragic news, and should be emulated by other business owners.
Many people should learn from him. Apollo had already brought his children in business. For example, his son Harold has been the MD now of Aponye Uganda Limited. His son Brodis has been handling the transport section. His son Peter has been handled in the hotel section. So you could see planning way ahead, not like many businesses where you find that succession is a problem. The children are just in America. Where I know we are waiting for children, these children are spread over the world. We have some who are coming from Canada. We have some who are coming from Washington. We have others who are coming from Germany. We have some who are coming from London. We have another one coming from Dubai, and all of them will be here by Sunday evening.
Aponye was praised as a job creator employing many Ugandans.
Great in business, great in politics, great in him being a human being and relating with the population. So I'm glad that you're also here to join us in expressing our solidarity with the family, with the friends and with relatives. But this is a big, big loss for the country.
Because he was a businessman, he had factories, he contributed jobs, he contributed to the national economy by paying taxes, and was a great man, very simple. Despite the fact that he was wealthy, but he was very simple, very contributed a lot to the church, contributed a lot to the community.
According to the tentative burial program, Aponye will be laid to rest on Wednesday at his ancestral home in Muhanga Village, Ruchiga District. On Sunday, July 9th, the body will be brought from the funeral home for the official vigil at his home in Lubowa.
Now the body is at the funeral home, and then on Sunday, it will be brought here for the official vigil at 4 p.m. Here in Lubowa. Then after, on Monday at 10 a.m., we shall go for church service at the Lubaga Cathedral, and thereafter we move to Muhanga, and then on Tuesday at 10 a.m., the body will go to Muhanga Catholic.
Report by Jariat Namuwaya for the news.